Hey guys, it's Jess, and welcome back to my Facebook Live. So you know every day I'm committed to coming on here, sharing some tips and strategies for you on how to help your child with autism. Sometimes I'm in my office and I have my professional lighting on, and sometimes, like just now, I have an extra couple minutes, I'm in my car, and I just want you to know, no matter where I go and no matter what I'm doing, I'm thinking about you. Autism doesn't stop for your family, so I never stop making content for you. So today I'm gonna create a video on, or to share some strategies on one of the things that's probably the most difficult of having a child with autism. You know, and I'm not a parent, but this is what parents tell me over and over and over, is one of the things they struggle with the most. And that's when something's wrong, their child not being able to tell them what's wrong. You know, one of the most frustrating things I can imagine as a parent is, you know, your child's crying and they're sick, but they can't tell you, you know, mom, I have a headache, or mom, my arm is bothering me, mom, my belly's bothering me, right? So how did you get them to tell you that? Well, in ABA, I've been doing ABA for 12 years, and what I've found is that a lot of therapists, they will teach kids to identify their body parts. So they'll say, okay, show me your nose, and the kid will touch their nose, and show me your head, and then they'll get pictures of people, and they'll have you point to the body parts and other people, and then they'll do it on themselves and say, okay, touch my shoulder, touch my belly. So you can have a child identify the body parts, but that doesn't necessarily translate to them being able to tell you if something's wrong. If you tell them to touch their stomach, they might be able to find their stomach, but that doesn't mean if they have a stomach ache, they're telling you that their stomach hurts. So I found a strategy that I've used for the last few years, and it's worked really, really well. You know, going back at, I wish I knew this 10 years ago when I first started, 12 years ago when I first started, but for the last few years I've been doing it, and it's made such a radical difference for me. In fact, I shared it on LinkedIn, and someone said, another BCBA said, wow, this article blew my mind, I'm gonna start this immediately. And I wanted to come on and I wanted to share this with you. So when you're teaching body parts, it's not enough to have a child identify their body part. You have to have them identify sensations on their body part. So rather than telling a child, touch my nose, you know, you would maybe touch the child's arm and say, where am I touching? Or you can put something cold, like a hand warmer, or like an ice pack, or just like a wet towel, and you have them identify where they're feeling a sensation. Now, obviously, you're not going to do anything that hurts the child or that's uncomfortable to the child. You don't want it that it's aversive. If the child doesn't like the sensation of the heat pack, or doesn't like the sensation of the ice pack, or maybe it's tickling, you know, whatever it is, you want to make sure you're not doing something aversive. I want to really, really clarify. We're not hurting the child, and we're not doing anything they're uncomfortable with. But whatever sensation the child's comfortable with, it could be you have a brush, like one of those brushes that are sensory brushes, OT brushes, and you're rubbing it on them. It could be a toothbrush. It could be some sort of like vibrating jiggler that I know a lot of kids like that. Again, it could be an ice cube. It could be a heat pack. Whatever it is, you're going to create a sensation on the child's body part and ask them, where do you feel? You know, where do you feel cold? Where do you feel hot? Where do you feel the tickles? So they're starting to identify feelings on their body parts. That is going to be a huge game changer for so many kids, because once they learn to identify sensations on their body parts, they're going to start to be able to tell you when they're not feeling well, when they're feeling pain, when they're feeling poorly. So I really hope that you start doing that immediately with your child at home or your therapist. If your therapist, this is not a technique many people know about. This is one that I kind of just was really praying about in my own personal practice, and I've never actually seen any other therapist do this. There might be other people that do it, but you know, so talk to your therapist, share this video with them, tell them about it, make sure they're doing this. If you are a therapist, share this with your teams, you know, and start doing this immediately, because I've seen huge, huge results for it. Maybe one day I'll even do a study on it. I don't have that data to show that now, other than, you know, this is just my sharing what I've learned, but that may be an awesome strategy. So if you're watching this on Facebook Live, head over to parenttrainingvideos.com. That's my YouTube channel. I posted 5 videos this weekend. There's tons of tips just like this, things you might not have thought of, or maybe things you have, but you want some clarity on it. So you can head over to there. Also go over to my email, go over to my website, drop your email in. I'll send you my 3 best eBooks totally free. You know, get my weekly emails, my blog posts. I have some amazing things coming out. I just had a friend today. He has autism. He wrote a blog article about what that looks like for him, and how, what it was, what it meant for him as a children. If you're a teacher, he shares some things that teachers did that really worked for him and some things that didn't work for him. I'm also going to be interviewing him tonight. He's amazing. He's going to be really just adding a ton of value. And if you're on my list, you'll get the copy of his interview and his blog post next week. So hopeeducationservices.com, get on the list, and I look forward to connecting with you there. Take care, guys.